لیاقت ایرانی، موقعیت جغرافیایی ایرانی، آمادگی ارتش شاهنشاهی، آمادگی ملت ایران برای این وضع جدیدی که در تاریخ 3000 سالش پیدا شده، مسلماً برای ایران یک رول بین‌المللی هم هست که ما قادر، آماده و لایق اجرای اون رول نجیب بین‌المللی هستیم.
We will be very sorry if President Sadat's initiative will not achieve the desired results, because the alternative is almost dreadful to think of. Whatever we can do in that direction, that is to facilitate just peace based on Resolution 242 and on the recognition of the rights of the Palestinian people. We will do.
Your Majesty, one of the gravest questions seems to be that of the right of return of Palestinians who are not living on the West Bank or the Gaza. For example, Palestinians who are in Lebanon. Prime Minister Begin's idea is that they should stay in Lebanon and be absorbed by that country. What do you think of that?
That will ruin Lebanon.
And do you think they should come back to the West Bank and have that as a home?
Well, if they wish so. But the question is that how many people can the West Bank absorb?
If the Israelis do withdraw from the Abu Rudess oil fields in the Sinai, as is suggested, as well as the Gideon Mifla Pass, it is said that the Shah of Iran will guarantee that Israel will have oil.
I have heard that question in Vienna, and my reply was that I was not the godfather of Israel. Who am I to guarantee that? First of all, Abu Rudess was not their property. It belonged to the Egyptians. They used that oil as long as they could.
Yes, but
you know, oil will not be denied to Israel. All the oil companies could sell oil to Israel. She will not be short of oil. She will probably have to pay for it. That's all.
Do you see any conflict between the social and economic demands of your people? About 50% of them can't read or write yet. And the amount you spend on weapons?
No, because we couldn't spend more either on illiteracy or other social things, because first of all we wouldn't have the teachers, and then for instance over hospitals we wouldn't have the doctors, the trained nurses, and it could create inflation too. Can I say that this year we are going to have a 40% national growth at constant prices, which is more than twice, or almost three times, the world record which was held by the Japanese?
What exactly is the essence of Your Majesty's dreams for Iran?
To regain the greatness of Iran could only be done in the human aspect of our past, to revive it and to take the best out of the thought of our forefathers, and being a prosperous country, a happy society based on social justice, that is today's creation, and marrying today with the past.
You seem to be a man who has got just about everything. A country with prospects, plenty of money, oil, all the things a country needs, and a ruler needs. Is there anything you're worried about? Have you got any worries?
Well, that would be very presumptuous of me by saying that one worry is not to be around before everything has been finished. The succession that I told you that I'm preparing the succession, one of the items of the succession is the political maturity of our people. And this, first of all, by becoming literate, the second, by getting into political parties, because otherwise it would be almost a jungle. I would like my people to register into solid, conscious, responsible political parties representing the spirit of our revolution.
امروز ایرانی رو نمیشه خرید، امروز ایرانی رو نمیشه بهش دستور داد که این ور برو اون ور برو بر ضد مملکت اقدام بکن. و این فکر میکنم که یکی از بزرگترین نه فقط افتخارات شماست ولی بزرگترین تضمین کننده آینده است که به هر صورت آینده ایران هر چی که باشد به دست ایرانی و به فکر ایرانی انجام خواهد شد.
تا به حال کسی با من در تدوین این 17 ماده انقلاب شریک نبود و هر چی آمده از فرماندهی به پایین صادر شد، ولی من که ابدی نیستم و برای تأمین مطمئن آینده مملکت سازمان های ما باید داشته باشیم که ثمره انقلاب ایران، ثمره کارهایی که در این چند سال انجام شده ایرا نه فقط تثبیت و نگهداری بکنه بلکه ریشه دارتر و عمیق‌تر انجام بده. به اندازه کافی گفته نمیشه در ایران که چه اتفاقاتی و چه جریاناتی هر روز هست. خیلی به نظر طبیعی عادی میاد، امروز میگم فلان کارخانه اونجا ایجاد شده، حالا کارخانه مثلا 1.5 میلیارد دلار سرمایه گذاری شده، مثل این که مثلا 4 تا آجیل در یک دکون آجیل فروشی درست شده و عرضه شده.
یک چیز ایرانی نباید اشتباه بکنه، موضوع فساد و دزدی با پول در آوردن از راه کار. اگر یک کسی کار کرد، زحمت کشید، پول در آورد، میلیاردر شد، به شرطی که مالیاتش رو بپردازه، این باید مورد علاقه هر کسی باشه. ولی نه اینکه ما بی خودی حسادت بکنیم به کسی که از راه صحیح و به اصطلاح جان کندن پول در آورده. پس چیکار میخواهید بکنن؟ برن یه مملکت دیگه مهاجرت بکنن، اونجا تازه از راه فعالیت شدید به جای برسن؟ خوب چرا مملکت خودشون نکنن این کارو؟ پس این دو موضوع رو کاملا از هم جدا بکنید. پول در آوردن از راه شرافت و کار و پرداخت مالیات و اون فساد که خب البته دزدی و دغلی و هرزگی است و اون ما نمیبخشیم، اون یکی رو اتفاقا باید تشویق بکنیم. کما اینکه چند سال پیش من اینو گفتم، عدالت بعضیا گفتن در ایران در این است که چون اون موقع میگفتم امیدی نیست که ایران به جای برسه، پس عدالت در بدبختی هم است، در بیچارگی هم است، در فقر هم است. حالا اسمش نمیارم که اینو گفته مرده. من میگم امروز عدالت در ایران در رفاه هم است و وسایلی باید فراهم بکنیم که هر کسی که یه قدر غیرت داشت و یه قدر کار داشت به رفاه حتمی برسه. از اون بالاتر هر چی بیشتر گیرش اومد به قول معروف چه بهتر، ولی باز هم به همون شرط، پرداخت مالیات حقه قانونی.
I'm curious, why are you willing to sit and answer these questions?
Because I like these kind of provocations. It gives me the opportunity of clearing, clarifying things that unfortunately are said and not always answered. I am dedicated to my country because this is the most beautiful thing that could happen. What could I take away with me when I go in the grave? Not even dress, maybe just a piece of white cloth, that's all. So what I've got to take with me in the grave is history.